Hi everyone, how's it going? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to today's Let's Play video of OMSI 2 Bus Simulator. And the map we're going to be using today, folks, will be the Westcountry 3, and we're going to be doing the Route 12 to Paignton. And we do have the Arriva post 2018 livery as well, although I've just used a random fleet number for this bus in terms of the registration, as I don't think it exists on any bus, to be honest. But anyways, let's just turn on the controls and everything. But first, I'm just going to jump in the cab and then we can get this bus set up for service, okay? Right folks, I'm just going to let the air tanks fill up naturally, and then I'm just going to set up the destinations, and then we'll be going in about 3 minutes or so, okay? As it takes about 3 minutes to get the air tanks and stuff charged up, and I will use the route assist, as not really played OMSI 2 for quite a long time, okay? And I don't want to get lost, as I can't remember the route entirely, as I've not really played much on OMSI 2, as I've mainly been focused on Train Simulator. So all being well, I will do more OMSI 2 videos, including London, as that is my favourite payware map. But for now, I'm just going to do some Let's Plays on here, and I'm just going to get the bus all set up and ready to go, okay? Thank you. As you can probably tell, folks, I really do enjoy the Volvo B7TL Alexander ALX400, and in my opinion, I find this bus quite fun to drive. And if the handling of this 3D bus is anything to go by, these buses seem to be faster off the mark than the Alexander Dennis Enviro 200s, in my opinion, anyways. Then again, to be honest, it is a Volvo, so in my opinion, Volvo do make excellent buses, and the Volvo B7TL is definitely my favourite bus from Volvo, unlike the newer stuff, as there is the power, as I was saying there. These buses do have plenty of power, and the power rating on this bus is about 250 horsepower, of which is the version I'm using here. And this version is a VoIP version, as where the ones in my area, they have the ZF transmission, of which, to be honest, the ZF Ecomap gearboxes are my favourites, as they do have a nice sound to them. But to be honest, I do like the VoIP sounds as well. Anyway, folks, keeping on topic, and that's this Westcountry 3 map. This is the first time I've actually done the route number 12, and in my opinion, this is quite a nice route to do. As I was saying there, this is quite a nice route to do, in my opinion, and the development team of this map have done a grand job on the design and the features and the detail, because to be honest with you, folks, I do like the open roads combined with city driving and country driving as well. But anyways, I'm just going to let these vans and this taxi pass us first, and then we can get going to the next stop, because I think I'm early, and I might have caught up with the other bus, that is an Alexander Dennis Enviro 400. So that could be the reason why I only had just one passenger, you know. But anyways, as I was saying there, I'm just going to follow this route through, and we will be going straight ahead, as I'm in the right hand lane, so I don't want to take any wrong turns, as I do try to drive properly, but I'm a wee bit rusty on playing OMSI 2, as it's been about 3 months or so since I last played this game, so I'm just practicing and getting my skills back up just for this let's play anyways. I don't want to improve the more I play the game again. Well, folks, looks like my instincts were correct after all, as we have caught up with the other bus. So what I'm going to do just so that I can pick up some passengers. Unless this is the terminal point for this route, I'm gonna go ahead and see if I can find more passengers, and I will do a return journey. Otherwise, this will be quite a short video. But nonetheless, I'm definitely enjoying this one. you can probably tell there, folks, I've never done this route before. So I'm going to now do the return journey on the number 12. As you may see in the traffic, folks, you may see some of the step vans, such as the UPS ones. I'm working on a repaint mod for those, just to paint them into DHL, Royal Mail and UPS, as represented by the Renault Dodge 50 vans. And once I get those done, I will cover that in another video, but that's the reasons why they are in this map. So the next thing for me to do is to change the route and do the return journey on the number 12, and then we can get started. Okay, folks, these vehicles are not moving, so I'm gonna have to cheat here a little and just go. Make sure I don't miss the turn in the process, as to be honest, the AI traffic, is definitely not the sharpest tool in the shed, metaphorically speaking, and it is a sandwich short of a picnic. That's just my terminology on it anyways. Likewise folks, just picking up some passengers as we do the return journey on the route 12.
Driving this like a madman?
Well folks, just gotta wait for a turn when the lights change to green, and then we can take this turn to the right and be on our way again. To be honest, I think it's getting around lunchtime on this map, so the traffic is starting to increase as everyone goes on their lunch break, perhaps to do a bit of shopping and that kind of stuff. So I do like the added realism of the emergency vehicles and stuff as well, as it's about right. It's not too much overkill like it was in the London map when it first came out, as they were about every 2 minutes or so. But anyways, we're just gonna pick up some more passengers here, so we will have quite a full load.
Hello.
What? Ah, yeah.
It's definitely great that we've got more passengers this time, as it should make the return journey more realistic, as I only had one passenger coming down. So just gotta wait for these lights to change and these vehicles to move, and then we will be on our way again.
Hello.
Thank you.
God, that was close.
Right folks, that is the end of the Let's Play. As you can probably see, there is some glitches with the AI bus pathing, although I'm not sure if this has been fixed or not, so I will see if there is a newer version of this map, as I did download this originally when it was first launched, so I will check for some updates to see if there's any fixes for that, but overall this is a great map, and to use my favourite type of bus on this map, that definitely makes it more fun in my opinion. But anyway folks, that's all for now. As always, I do appreciate all your feedback, comments, and of course any suggestions for other Let's Play videos and stuff. You know, as you can probably tell, I've done a lot of train simulator just lately, but now I'm playing OMSI 2 again, and I do plan to cover other transport simulators as well. I will do more videos of OMSI 2, and I will use this bus again, perhaps in the stagecoach livery and stuff, once I can sort out the glitches with the graphics. And I may save those as DDS instead of TGA files, as they don't use so much memory. So I may alter the format on those to see if that fixes the dark shadow issue that I'm getting on the stagecoach liveries on this bus. So, well, I should be back up and running again properly on OMSI 2, and I do look forward to trying out many of the new add-ons that are coming out for OMSI 2 as well. So all being well, it won't be too long before I'm doing Let's Plays on those too. But anyway folks, I just want to say to you, if you made it this far in the video, a big thank you for watching, and as always, have a good week or weekend, take care of yourselves, all the best, and God bless. See you all in the next upload, everyone, and that's all for now. Cheerio, and all the best.